Just as promised, this week I'll take a look at another short from The Lord of the Rings, again animated by Chris Hatala. I will also try to share some of the process because I believe it's really interesting. I hope you find this as exciting as I do, so let's dive in and try to learn. So here we are, taking a look at this challenging short, animated by Chris Hatala for The Lord of the Rings, The Return of the King. I'll try to keep this short, but I like that I'm doing this in real time and thinking while I'm learning and sharing it. So let's dive in and see one of the earlier versions. These were shared by Chris himself online. So this is early blocking, timing isn't great, the mechanics aren't yet polished. This is a basic idea that you can show to the client or your supervisor and see if that's what they want. The idea behind this short is that, you know, the spider is a female, Shelob is her name actually, and strangely enough she cares for the food because she doesn't get good meat often, as the Gollum Sméagol mentions before in the movie. So there would be a motherly aspect to the behavior of the spider. It became clear though early enough that there should also be aggression. And we can see in this early shot that the digidouble, like Frodo, isn't yet fully animated. Of course, it's very basic blocking. So let's move on to another take. Here we are. This version is a bit different than the final one. He starts falling back. So she either catches him or he hits the floor. Different idea, and we can see there's a dangling foot here as well. A little more violent now, she pokes him and rolls him faster and harder. Still, the timing isn't as the final. Okay, I'm gonna move on to the next one. Here we are. This is now closer to the final. And I actually like this because it's way more aggressive and it's the movement of the spider is more creature-like, more violent and with twitches and faster movement. But of course, they still wanted this motherly aspect. So they changed it a little bit from this. Next take we have is this, which is closer to the final. Very violent and very creature-like. And yeah, I will move on to the next take, which I think is the first cloth pass. It's interesting to see how many things are hidden with this cape. But now the spider is almost, I think it's fully animated to the final version of it. Also, it's interesting that there was another cloth pass to simulate the web. And it is made with cloth, with some alpha and transparency, and some technical magic that I'm not even able to describe. I will focus on the animation. So let's dive in and take a look at the final shot now. And let's look at the animation. I love that here the animator can control where we look the whole time. For example, here we can see like when the hands are rolling, boom, boom. These are like the strongest motion we see on the screen, and that's where the audience is looking. This is something I recently started thinking about after starting the Spangella workshop with Jean-Denis Haas. And I'm trying to incorporate this in my animation. So let's take a look at the digi double here. He starts falling back. The body overlaps, like the head overlaps as the back is leading him down. And the moment the spider grabs him here, excuse my bad drawing, the head starts rotating, gets the impact, bam. So the head rolls backwards. Let's pretend this is a good arrow. And as he's lifting him like this, we get this beautiful pose here, and the head just drags behind the motion. Then she pushes him to roll him, and we get this beautiful rolling arm with this arc here before she grabs his arm and flips it again. The idea behind the animation of Frodo is just basic overlap and reacting to the impact of different body parts. But I like how he animated him before this part where the web is holding him and everything just basically rotates at the same time almost. Here he has some beautiful offsets to the body and everything is animated separately. So look how his spine is rotated here. It's a beautiful, beautiful work by Chris in this shot. And here is the same as he's pushing his back and boost already the arm that way with his leg. The hips are still not rotated, and then she keeps pushing him with this leg around. And the whole time the head is overlapping while still keeping it clear enough with beautiful silhouettes. Also, it's interesting because subconsciously the animators add things, even not subconsciously, but maybe I would say on a subconscious level, animators add things that invoke a specific feeling, because animators are artists and there's a lot in someone's animation shot that you can break down and find. And to me it's interesting because for example the motherly aspect in this shot, Chris was looking at reference and used reference from La Pietà, Michelangelo's La Pietà. How cool is that? If you don't know what La Pietà is, it's this. So these are really interesting, and I wish I knew more about the reference that animators use in their shows. So let's take a quick look at the spider as well. What I find really interesting is that every time she is climbing the wall, look at the transference of the weight. The moment she's pushing this leg to the wall, the body is reacting. And the body is rotating that way. And you can see this. I don't know if I can call this a shoulder, but this is basically moving as well. And the mechanics of this shot is they're really interesting as well, because this whole motion is very complicated. And everything is constantly moving, nothing is dead on the screen. So she's trying to keep balance here, because this part at the back where the web is coming out of, like here, this part that I'm painting over, is constantly moving back and forth, left and right, as he's spreading the web. And the whole time, with great offsets, the head is counter rotating to that, as you can see here. So when this is rotated that way, so this is rotating this way. If I go back to this frame, the body is rotating this way and the head is rotating that way. This is beautiful, and the little details of her, I don't know how to call them, teeth, they're constantly like opening and closing and moving with beautiful offsets, so it feels so creaturey and so disgusting at times, but this was the purpose, like it's a spider. And yeah, I think the biggest thing I get from this is the great body mechanics and how challenging it must be to control so many legs. And of course, biggest thing I think is the animator is moving everything, nothing stays dead, and everything works together. So when the back of the body is rotating that way, the head is rotating the other way, when these legs are pushing, it will affect the body. And this is beautifully done by Chris Hatala in this shot. And another big thing is that, like I mentioned before, is that he controls what we see, where we look at as viewers. And I really admire the animation of this shot, and I hope I can animate cool creatures like that soon. It's a great privilege to work in a movie like this, at least in my perspective. Yeah, I tried not to make this so long, but I like also how the spacing of the legs work. So here, like this leg I'm looking at now, this leg, it speeds up, pops, bam, and then almost linearly it moves around the body, spreading the web. These little things are constantly moving and pushing the web out, handing it to the other legs. This is a brilliant shot, animated in an awesome way. And I hope you've learned by watching this, because I think I did. Yeah. So I'm gonna end this now. And I will do more of this in the future. Thanks for watching. Enjoy. Bye.